morning, everyone. My name is Pragati, and I am an assistant professor working in the St. Martin's Engineering College in SLS department. I am going to discuss the topic related to dielectrics. So, before discussing the topic dielectrics, we will be knowing about under what class the solids are classified as. Our solids are classified into three types. First one is conductors. Insulators. And the another class of the solids is semiconductors. So we already know about what is conductor and what is insulator. We already know about in the conductors, since the energy gap between the conduction band and the valence band overlaps. So I need not to draw this. I have to draw. This is your conduction band, and if this is your valence band, so both the energy bands will be almost overlapping with one another. The conduction band and the valence band will be almost overlapping with one another. That means your electron, if it is present in the valence band, that can immediately combine with the conduction band and can form the current. That means your conductors are the classification of that particular solids which conducts the current. And your insulators, in case of insulators, we have seen the energy gap between the conduction band and the valence band is so much large. It's so much large that no electron can cross that particular energy gap and can come into the conduction band and recombine. So there is no recombination between the holes in the valence band and the electrons in the conduction band. And that's how we can say if the energy gap is large between the conduction and the valence band, no electron can go to the conduction band and conduct the current. And that's why insulators are the classification of the solids which do not conduct the current, and we can also say that they don't have the free charge carriers. They don't have any free charge carriers. While in the case of the conductors, we already know since there are free charge carriers, since we have here the number of free charge carriers, that's why they are able to combine with holes in electrons, and that's why they can produce the current. Since there are free charge carriers here. There is one more classification which is called as semiconductors. In case of semiconductors, what we are seeing, in case of semiconductors, they are the types of metals which we are making with the help of the insulators only, but we are generating p-type metals and n-type metals. How we are generating p-type metals and n-type metals? In the case of p-type metals, we are adding to your particular metal the trivalent impurity. If you are adding a trivalent impurity to your impure metal, if you are adding a trivalent impurity to a pure metal, then we are generating a p-type material. In p-type material, we are getting excess number of holes. So we can say that holes are the majority charge carriers in case of p-type semiconductors, and there is one more type which is called as n-type material. In case of n-type material, to your pure semiconductor we add a pentavalent impurity. So once we add a pentavalent impurity, we can say that there are number in excess, your electrons are produced. So in excess, electrons are produced. So electrons are the free charge carriers in the n-type semiconductor, and the holes are the free charge carriers in the p-type semiconductors. Now get back to again the dielectrics topic. What we have seen in the dielectrics, we know that we have classified the solids under conductors, insulators and semiconductors. But under what classifications your dielectrics is coming? Under insulators, there are some materials which are called as dielectrics. But we can say that all dielectrics are insulators, but all insulators are not dielectrics. This is a point to be noted down. We call all dielectric material as insulators, but every insulator we cannot consider as dielectric. Why? Because in dielectric, the charges are placed such that they can polarize themselves whenever an electric field is applied. So, in the case of dielectric, we are having two classes of dielectrics. One is non-polar dielectrics. Non-polar dielectrics, and the other class of dielectrics is polar dielectrics. In the case of the non-polar dielectrics, the examples are the atoms, homo atoms. Homo atoms, that means the molecules which have been made by similar atoms can be considered as an example of non-polar dielectrics, like O2 molecule, H2 molecule, benzene molecule, which has made up of a similar carbon chain, we also can consider as an example under the non-polar dielectrics. But what happens in the non-polar dielectrics? Under non-polar dielectrics, they doesn't have any permanent dipole moment. And why they doesn't have any permanent dipole moment? Suppose if we are considering the case of O2, if we see the Lewis structure of O2, if we are seeing the Lewis structure of O2, the distance between the bond length, is very short. Since the distance between the bond length is very short, the centers of positive and negative charges tend to coincide. Since the bond length is very short, I can say here that the positive charge center and the negative charge center, coincides. Here, they coincide, right? In case of polar dielectrics, we are seeing those molecules which already have a positive center and a negative center, like we are having HCl molecule. Now here, there comes heteroatoms. Here we have learned about homoatoms, and here we learn about heteroatoms, means different molecule. Suppose I am taking HCl, and if I draw the Lewis structure of HCl, what it will be like? HCl, H plus and Cl minus. Now if you are able to see, there is certain bond length or bond distance between the two types of atoms, and that is why positive center and negative center, here they doesn't coincide, but here they are forming a certain dipole moment. So the positive and the negative are separated by some distance d, and that's why here we can call that they are forming a permanent dipole. They are having a permanent dipole. Of non-polar dielectrics, if I say how to draw the dielectrics of this, if I am drawing at all a dielectric material for this, I can draw where the positive and the negative charges is coinciding, similar atom molecules, positive and negative charges coinciding. But in the case of the polar dielectrics, how will I draw the dielectric material? Since they are already having the permanent dipoles, I will be drawing like, so already the dipole moments they have, but they are randomly arranged because we have not given any kind of electric field here. And in this case also, when positive and negative are so close, they are neutralized. Here also we have not provided any electric field. So the net dipole moment that will be coming out of your non-polar dielectrics is zero. And also the net dipole moment which will be coming out of the polar dielectrics is also zero. Until and unless we apply the electric field here, if we apply the electric field here, the positive and negative charges tend to displace a little bit. They tend to displace a little bit and they try to arrange them or align them in the direction of the electric field. What happens when we are applying the electric field in the polar dielectrics? Your permanent dipoles, which are earlier randomly arranged, while applying the electric field, they will all align themselves in the direction of the electric field. So this is the case of the non-polar dielectrics and the polar dielectrics. In the case of non-polar, we are having no permanent dipole moment. And in the case of the polar dipoles, polar molecules or dielectrics, we are having a permanent dipole moment. Now we will discuss one more thing, that while arranging your dielectrics inside parallel plate capacitor, how it is increasing the capacitance of a charged plate capacitor. So we used to say that why we use the dielectric materials in order to increase the capacitance of the charge plates. But how it is increasing actually? What work your dielectric is doing inside the capacitor plates that it is increasing the capacitance in a certain amount? See here, whenever we are inserting the dielectric material between the charge capacitor plates, and if I am giving these charge capacitor plates to a battery, this is the positive terminal and this is the negative terminal. If I am giving the positive terminal of the battery, this plate will be positively charged. And the negative terminal, from the negative terminal, the plate will be negatively charged. Now, the positive terminal charges the plate of the capacitor, one plate of the capacitor, to the positive charges, and the negative terminal of the battery charges the another plate of the capacitor to the negatives. Now, if at all I am removing the dielectric from here, I am removing the dielectric here, what will be the voltage which will be maintaining here will be the difference same as the battery. So whatever the battery, if you are giving 2 volts battery here, then the potential which is developed between the positive and the negative charges is also for the 2 volts. And if at all if I am removing this battery, the charges are going to be stuck there itself and the negative charges are going to be stuck here only, and no difference will be there, still your capacitor plates will be charged by the 2 volt potential difference. But we don't want this, but we want to increase the capacitance. How we are going to increase the capacitance? Now, I have introduced a dielectric material in between the charged capacitor plates. Charged capacitor plates because this is positively charged and this is negatively charged. Now, if I am talking about the non-polar dielectric, if I have placed the non-polar dielectric here, how your charges are going to be polarized when I am keeping between the electric field, negative, positive. So all the negative charges will align towards the positive plane, and all the positive charges will be going to align towards the negatively charged plane. Once this alignment is finished, I'm again removing the battery from here. Now what is happening? All the capacitor plates on which I have earlier, which is positively charged, the negative of the dielectrics is neutralizing the positive charge on the capacitor plates. All the negatives of the dielectric, which have been earlier negatively charged, is neutralizing the positive of the dielectric. And similarly, here also, the positive of the dielectrics is neutralizing the negative charge on this plate. Okay? All the positive will be neutralizing the negative charge on this plate. Now, what is happening if I am neutralizing the charges which are earlier present on the capacitor plates? If I am neutralizing, that means that the number of charges which were earlier, the accumulation of the charges which were earlier on this plate, are getting reduced. If the number of accumulated charges which were charged earlier due to the battery are getting reduced, that means I am reducing the voltage here. What I am doing? Reducing the voltage. Why? Because earlier, when the capacitor plates were already charged, the potential difference was 2 volts. Now what I am doing, I am making these charges which are earlier on the plate to get disappear by neutralizing them with the help of the dielectric. So in order, while I am neutralizing, so there is decrement of the voltage. From the 2 volts, now your voltage is decremented. Now you will ask that if the voltage is getting decreased, how the capacitance of the capacitor plates are increased? See here, C is equals to Q by V, charge by voltage. If I am decreasing the voltage here, By introducing the dielectrics, the capacitance of the capacitor plates are increasing because C is inversely proportional to V. Leave about the charge, leave this charge, whatever the charge present on the capacitor plates, but if the voltage of the capacitor plates between the capacitor plates is decreasing, the capacitance is increasing. Let's see the another case of the same thing when we are leaving the battery on. Here we are removing the battery, and we will see a one more case where we are not removing the battery. The battery is charging your plates of the capacitor, we have removed the battery. And we will see the another case where we will not remove these batteries. Suppose I am not removing this battery this time, and your plates of the capacitor, your capacitor plates is this time charged with positive, and your capacitor plate of this side is charged with negative. And similarly, whatever the polarization happened in the non-polar dielectrics, that same polarization will be happening, negative, positive, now, but at this time only, I am leaving the battery still here. What is happening? The negative charges of the dielectric, which have been aligned here beside the capacitor, positive capacitor plate, are neutralizing the positive charges on the capacitor plates. They are neutralizing the positive charges on the capacitor plates, and the positive charges which are aligned in this side are neutralizing the negative charge accumulation of the capacitor plates. Now, even if I am neutralizing the charges on both the sides of the capacitor plates, your voltage is decreasing. Earlier we have seen already the voltage will going to be decreased if I am removing the charges from the capacitor plate. But in this case, I have left the battery on in the circuit. I have left the battery connected to the circuit. Earlier, I have not left the battery connected. This time, when I am having the battery connected, even though it is neutralizing the charges, but the function of the battery is what? Whatever it will do, but it will make the potential difference between the two charge plates constant. Suppose the battery is of 2 volts. If at all we are neutralizing some charges from the capacitor plates, but the function of the battery is, it will again add some more charges. It will again add some more charges to the positive plate, and from a negative plate, it will add some more negative charges. And it will again add the charges so that the voltage is going to be constant, 2 volts. The voltage is going to be constant. Earlier, in the first case, what was happening? Your voltage was going to be decreased because we were removing the charges from the capacitor plates. But in this case, we are charging the capacitor plates with the positive, again with the negative, so that the voltage between the capacitor plates is going to be same. But then how we are increasing the capacitance here? Again, the same formula we will see. C is equals to Q by V. But this time, the voltage is constant. This time, your voltage is constant, but your charges on the plate are increasing. Since the charges on the plate are increasing, that's why your capacitance is increasing. So even if you left the battery not connected to the circuit, and even if you connect the battery to the circuit, in both the cases, the capacitance of the charge plate capacitor is going to increase due to the application of the dielectrics. Because we have introduced the dielectrics between the capacitor plates, in both the cases, the capacitance is going to be increased. So this was my topic related to the dielectrics. Thank you.
Okay, 2 minutes.
So this case, this can be called as a first case. This can be called as a first case where we have not introduced the dielectrics. We have not introduced the dielectrics, and when we have connected the battery. After the plates are charged, then we have removed the battery from here. When we have removed the battery, the charge is going to be still the same on both the capacitor plates. Okay, 2 volts. The charge is going to be still the same because because we have not introduced, only a free space medium is there between it, which is called as air medium. Only air medium is there, no dielectric has been introduced, the charges are going to be same, the potential difference is same. 2 volts, 2 volts, and the battery also are of 2 volts. Thank you.